leadership development training for young women in Goa, India, who are at risk of sex trafficking. So I created, implemented, and then evaluated a leadership training with the hope of increasing the girls' leadership skills that they could use not only in their daily lives, but in future leadership roles. So overall, the results were really positive. The girls all made multiple requests for more of these kinds of trainings. They said that other people need to learn this. So these are all graphs that show girls' responses in a pre-assessment before they actually went through the trainings, and then a post-assessment after they went through the trainings. And overall, all the results were pretty positive. And I think that's a reflection not only of the training, but of the fact that I spent a lot of time with them as well, building trust, establishing connections with them.
Hi, my name is Whitney Turrentine, and this is my final year at the MDP program at UF. This is my poster of what I did for the field practicum, and I was in Longido, Tanzania, so in northern Tanzania, monitoring the global framework for climate services, which are trainings of extension workers, right? So a little bit about my poster. I'm sort of explaining the context of Longido here, and Longido is a very dry, semi-arid region that's prone to really big bouts of food insecurity. So my program was really trying to understand how extension workers could best assist local farmers and pastoralists and provide them with climate information so they can make the best livelihood decisions so they could be less food insecure. So I'm just going to go through a couple of steps. Here's just the basic timeline of the Global Framework's activities in Tanzania. Here's a bit about my methods. I did mainly qualitative methods, like semi-structured interviews, and everything was based on themes. So here's just an organization of the responses of my extension workers based on the themes that I had for them. And in the end, we realized that there were a lot of challenges that extension workers had in understanding the actual trainings. In general, in Tanzania, everyone speaks Swahili, but all of the trainings were in English. So we advised that the training should be put mainly in Swahili or just have word-to-word translation, and also to incorporate indigenous climate knowledge into their trainings.
Hi, I'm Matt. Irving is on his way. We worked in Bogota, Colombia, working with a brewery, the Barium Brewery, which is a smaller part of the larger Seb Miller. Just going through the poster a little bit. So in the beginning, we wanted to just give a little brief background on CSR and what that means, what it is, and how it affects sustainability. A little bit about what we were asked to do. We also have here the context and who we were working with. This was kind of our contextual framework is the different parts that make up CSR and their Sam Miller breweries, and we were specifically working with the employees. A little bit of history of Colombia's Bavarian breweries. And then we get into their baseline, what we found there, a little bit of where we were working. We had 72 employees that we interviewed, did focus groups and semi-structured interviews with them.